So, all right, my friends, let's start the morning sessions of the first talk of Irina Arefyeva, holographic QCD for Nika, please.
Okay, thank you. It is my pleasure to give a talk at the session of QUAR conference dedicated to Andrei Dmitrievich Sakharov Sentential. I will present the result of theoretical studies of QUAR gluon matter under condition of high baryon density, which are supposed to be studied at NICA. By theoretical treatment, I mean mainly the graphic study. So I will go to find result relevant for NICA. The outlook of my talk will be the following. I will start to describe your expected QCD phase diagram. Then I will show what we get from graphic perspective, and then I conclude. Okay, the first few comments on garography. Garography is nowadays one of the most effective tools to study quantum non-equilibrium system or strong interacting many-body system. This system includes ultra-relativistic heavy ions, cold atom system, quantum simulation, etc. Garography translates the physics of quantum many-body system into dual classical gravitational problem in the space-time with one extra dimension. Then let me show you expected QCD phase diagram. Here is a plane T and mu, and there are several phase transition lines. To describe them, let me first show the old Kabiba-Parisi form of QCD phase diagram. We can see here just one transition line, which describes transition from hadronic phase to QUAR gluon plasma. And here I present I indicated in this diagram the main experiment in which this phase diagram supposed to be studied. Let me remind the study of a phase diagram within one of our main objection, my main goal in all this new experimental program Okay, and also here I present some result from lattice. With lattice, the main problem is the absence of result for non-zero chemical potential. And here is presented the dependence of phase transition type on quark mass. And here is a physical point. So for zero chemical potential, somehow we are in crossover regime. And if we increase mass of quark, then we come to first order phase transition. Here is the picture which presents you how this domain changes the size when we deal with chemical potential. We can trust this result for imaginary chemical potential, and a real chemical potential is obtained by analytical continuation. Here is a comparison of a diagram of a QCD diagram obtained from lattice calculation. Lattice is indicated with green, and I don't know, with light brown, and there are several points from freeze-out data, in particular for B-manager scanner program, and there are some calculations from phenomenology. So, roughly speaking, from all this consideration, we can say the following, that for light quark, we expect the diagram, which look like here, is presented here, dot line show the crossover, solid line shows the first order phase transition. So, at LHC, experimentally, we know that we are in the regime of crossover, and also this is supported by lattice calculation. But lattice calculation show us that for heavy quark, we should have this type of diagram. There are more lines which separate different phases. There is a line which separate describe color phase transition, and there is one very interesting line which describe so-called region describe quarkionic phase, and this line describe the change from free baryon to dense baryon. And there are some indications that these two lines can shrink. So our goal is to get this result from galography. And there is one more parameter which is very special for from our point of view for Heaviside collision. This is so-called anisotropy parameter. It is obvious this is a picture, very schematical picture for collision, where is a collision line, and here is, if you deal, it is absolutely obvious where is a longitudinal, a transversal direction, they are not equivalent. And there is also for non-central collision, we can appear very strong magnetic field. So in this case, there is a reason to deal with full anisotropy, and with magnetic field, no problem how to specify it. But with first one, non-equivalence on longitudinal transversal can be specified by a rather special parameter. I will tell you something more about this. It is related with dependence of energy of total multiplicity, which was observed on ALICE several years ago. This dependence is given by this formula, energy in power 0.155. And many people try to reproduce this answer from galographic perspective using isotropic model, but without any success. We also participate in this activity, but we found with Nastya Golubtsova that if we take from the beginning some kind of anisotropic model, very special, they called Lifshitz type anisotropic model, then we can recover this dependence as is written here, that it is not big deal to get the answer just taking a nu equal to 4 and 5. By this paper, which we wrote almost 8 years ago, we started to discuss different possibility to deal with anisotropic galography, and we studied different, our main problem is it will be possible to see something on experiment. So, our model, we start from 5-dimensional metric. It's written here. There are three functions which specify anisotropy. This is a beckoning function, and this is warp factor. We deal with very special, some answer can be obtained for general function, but in our special case, we deal with this particular case, and our metric is specified by this parameter nu and this parameter b. This is for magnetic field, this is a longitudinal transversal anisotropy, and there is this so-called RAP factor. And for RAP factor, people who are
But what is F1, F2, FB?
F1, F2, this is a kinetic function, which depends of dilatonic potential, and V is, phi is dilaton, V is a dilatonic potential. In principle, when care, because we are dealing with...
There are not a field strength for the vector fields.
Yes, exactly. But in Austria, we can fix F1 and F2 and B, we're supposed to find from equation of motion. So
you have 3 abelian fields?
Three abelian fields.
Gravity and 1 scalar fields.
Yes. 3 abelian field, gravity, and 1 scalar field. For isotropic model, people deal you only with 1 abelian field, but to get an isotropic solution, we have to introduce two extra Maxwell field. And
isn't it too much for the model?
This is a phenomenological model. Our strategy is simple. We take some function with some parameter, calculate what we can calculate for mu equal to zero, b equal to zero, take a lattice data or experimental data, fit with function, and then prolongate our result for non-zero b and non-zero chemical potential. This is something like a Renon group approach. This is very typical, this is a very typical situation which is going, for example, which is doing by many groups. There are 100 or more paper on several hundred papers on this activity. What is special for us, this is just what we use with anisotropy related with longitudinal transversal anisotropy. This is very special for our group, and we have to use a special, we use a special background which specified our parameter chemical potential and baryonic density, and this is just a form of solution which we found. This is just to, I don't know, to make any comments, but we want to show that it is possible to find analytical answer or in quadrature for right quark, even for we can find explicit form for heavy quark, and we also found an answer for Gibrit solution. It's not so simple to find all this stuff, but we succeeded.
But in any way, this is exact solution, yes?
Yes, this is exact solution. Mm-hmm. Some of them are explicit, some of them are in quadrature. From my point of view, it's very important to found a solution, because in some sense we deal with semi-classical approximation in gravity, and semi-classical approximation, we have to find a solution. We cannot, this is not top-down approach, but maybe then we understand how can look our model. Maybe we will succeed to find some special string model to support what we do here, because to guess from the beginning some correct answer to in the future pretend to explain experiment is too much. Yes, from my point of view, we have to start several possibility. In at least this is exact solution. This is exact solution can be also generalized for the sitter. So there are some application of this resolving cosmology. In any case, if you have some exact solution, is interesting itself. But we pretend to describe by this strategy, but not only we, but there is a big group of people who thinking in this way. And what is more interesting, what is more intriguing in all this activity is a special non-monotonic dependence on temperature on horizon. Here I presented some very special example just to show you that this dependence could be, if you look horizon dependence on the temperature. So we look on this direction. We fix T and see how many zeta h correspond to the same T. You can get double-valued function with double-valued function, for example, for ADS, which is related to thermoscoping page transition. And even more, just recently, we found more exotic solution. And I spend a couple of pedagogical slides, which are very well known, just to you feel what kind of problem we deal here. Entropy dependence on horizon is very smooth, but temperature dependence on horizon is non-monotonic. Due to this fact, we get dependence of entropy of a temperature as presented here. We get a double valued function. This is a small black hole. This is for large black hole. Small because small corresponds to big zeta. And if you calculate the free energy, we need to calculate the free energy to find the stable phase. We get this answer presented, which was calculated by Hawking Page in the famous paper. It looks like this. But this is not the end of story. There is also some other configuration which look like this. So there is a competition between three and this, this and this. Obviously, win this one and that this one, because this is a higher. And this point, this red point, describe this famous Hawking Page phase transition. In our case, we get a more interesting, more rich structure, because in our case, there is this function is free, there is a region where this function is free valued. We get this form of dependence of entropy on temperature. As a consequence, we get more rich structure for free energy. We get so-called slow tail shaped. So, because usually the physical quantity, the probe background are smooth on zeta, but we are interested not dependence on the zeta, we don't know what is zeta. We know only about t. And for dependence of this probe on t, we get some non-smoothness. So we have, if there is some unstable region, the system pull down us to a stable region. And we get for our probe the first order phase transition. I guess I try to explain this, which should be clear. This is one of my main ingredient and main point in all this activity. Maybe I skip this. This is once again show you what is just few words, what is going, for example, if you calculate a string tension, for example, you calculate, you are in this point, you expect that there is a phase transition, quark, oh, I'm sorry, a quantum confinement here because we are on the right of so-called dynamical law. I cannot go to the detail, but just trust me, if I am in the right of the dynamical law, I should be in quark confinement phase. But it's not so, because this is unstable. I have to go here, but there is no confinement here. So this is, we have taken into account in all this calculation. And for example, in the same way, we can consider the change of density across the first order phase transition. This is a very important for us because there is an argument with first transition of this guy describe this quarkonium phase. I put here the sign because it's not quite quite rigorous argument, but still it is tempting to speculate that there is the quarkonium phase. Now, how many time? I think, okay. Now I have summarized here the picture, what we got after some time tedious, some kind of calculations which take a lot of machine time, but nevertheless, here is a picture look like this. For light quark, our model give us the curve which look like this. There is an empty space, which is very important because this area is supposed to reproduce RHC data. But if you increase the anisotropy, then this gate is closed. For heavy quark, situation is quite different. The first order phase transition right here. If you increase anisotropy, this line goes down. And if you take into account magnetic field, the situation is also very similar. And you know, there are many experimental efforts to find so-called CEP, critical endpoint. This is a very important characteristic. It is important also in condensed metaphysics. And without any explanation, I'll just quote you this except what we got in our right quiet model. Okay, this is about, I finished to show to this very fast show what we get for the first order, first transition. Now let's consider the probe. For the probe.
Sorry, just a moment. All your results you reported so far are based on the solution you presented to you.
Yes, absolutely.
And they are
only for solution. Our solution are specified by some parameter as some arbitrary function, which from the beginning, this is a phase transition, there is no influence. We take the simplest one. Now,
You fix the some number in some way, I mean, new, yes, but you still have some functions, and how you fix this function?
Yes, we fix some and we vary. For example, we vary new, then the set point go along this line. Okay? Mm-hmm. And if we consider, if we consider the probe, there are a list of possible probes, but I'm going to discuss only few of them, temporal Wilsonov, special Wilsonov, and few remarks of Maxwell field. There are to specify temporal Wilsonov, we have to specify one direction, and because you have anisotropy, it is obviously that for a quark tangent, you get the answer which depends on the orientation. So if you have some phase transition from one orientation, we can get another phase transition line for another orientation. So we get the effect, so-called smoothing effect. This is a very interesting stuff. Here is written some explicit formula from this paper, but in more detail, maybe I will skip this, and I will show you some more, maybe more simple to explain. For example, as I said, we have a possibility to different choice of boundary condition. Nobody tell us to take some special one, but if we take very special, we can recover this lattice dependence of string tangent. This is picture from this paper. Always from this paper, except with green line. With green line, this is our calculation for right quark model for this particular number. By the way, this particular number was taken from, not this is not our data, but we took this answer with data because we reproduce a Regge spectrum. There was a big discussion about always number, but in different paper, but we took them and we got these results. After that, there is not enough time. We can calculate another quantity. Another very interesting quantity is the so-called special Wilson loop. Special Wilson loop is a rectangle. And rectangle in three is specified by direction of two sides, link. And with the orientation of this rectangle is the same as a bricks orientation. And bricks, because before we consider the different bricks dealing with entanglement entropy, but we use the same orientation here. And number got a string action, which is relevant to this temporal string has this form. And to find domain wall configuration, we have to solve very special equation. And this is just a notation. This is rectangle. A rectangle is not from the beginning is taken non-symmetrical along the length of in different direction. This is a technique we usually use in this calculation. And we found a very interesting result for different orientation, we get a different string tangent. for, and it is possible to write this answer in pure geometrical notion using a Philbin, and what is a profit? The profit is that there is a strong relation between, definite relation between string tension and drag forces. And drag forces themselves, they are related with energy loss, and energy loss is related to experiment. A lot of activity, what activity last 20 years is devoted to study energy loss using PCD calculation, enormous activity. It is not so difficult to find this answer from a graphical point of view.
Ирина, 10:25.
Okay, thank you. I am just okay. I not too much to say. Okay. Thank you very much. And we can calculate this drag forces also here. Also, we can calculate the drag forces for rotation case. We did with calculations with Nastya Golubtsova and Gurgulon just recently. So this is also very interesting stuff. And what is interesting that to calculate, as I said, drag forces are related with special string tension, and to calculate the string tension, we take this zeta star or domain wall, if it exists, or on horizon. So once again, we have a competition between green and cyan line, and in both cases, we have to take into account the stability of found solution. If there is some kind of competition, immediately we get phase transition. And here is presented the answer. This is along this line, there is a phase transition from one configuration to another one. The phase transition itself is a two-dimensional surface, for example, two-dimensional surface stretched on blue or green line. So we predict the line of phase transition for energy loss. This is a very serious result, and of course we're supposed to discuss with people who are doing experiment. So I think this is interesting. And you see that this surface change when we change anisotropy. But if you do not can say exactly parameter nu, because it could be dependence on the time, this is unstable, this is depending on the time solution, could be phase transition which lie just occupied this whole area. So okay, and the last point what I would like to say you is related to the photon emission function, starting from this paper by Jaffa, Moore, Stelmetz, and Kofton, I don't know how to pronounce this name, from more than 10 years ago, there is close relation between, the exact relation between a photon emission rate and green function, which in itself related due to Cougar relation with electric conductivity. So people, of course, calculate electric conductivity in different type of model. I presented here some recent references, and we did in our recent calculation, did this in anisotropic case. As I know, there is no anisotropic calculation before our paper, and it is interesting that we got extremely simple result. We got the ratio of electric conductivity to full anisotropy is given by our metric, and some extra function f. Please take attention. This is a fourth electromagnetic field which describe a perturbation. Maybe for somebody is too much, but this is what we can do in this approach. And this is the arbitrary function. Let's fix this function from lattice data. There are lattice data, which is presented here. This is lattice data, of course, it's presented for mu equal zero, because they can do. And our result are here with this dot dash line for mu equals zero is, I don't know how it's, you can see or not, but if we increase a little bit, just a little bit, a chemical potential appear with tail and appear with first order phase transition. And to fit our data with this lattice data, we took a special function f zero. And having this function f zero, we calculated conductivity for non-zero mu and non-zero b. And here is the result. One, we have a big list with different value, but I presented for you just a particular, two particular case. Maybe I show you in separated transparencies and you see this jump. So our prediction is a jump for photon emission function. Okay, so maybe I have to stop here, and my conclusion is here the following. We got a rich structure of phase transition in four dimensional space, T mu b nu. This is a typical three dimensions, more or less typical, but our specific is that Lipschitz type of behavior. And we have find interesting interplay between two type of phase transition, crossover and first order phase transition. As I already said, our strategy, our phenomenological strategy, I would stress that this graphic approach, which I use, is some kind of phenomenological approach. We fit some parameter for specific value of our mu equals zero, b equals zero. So we do what we can do. We take from outside some result, and our model provide dependence for non-zero mu. So what we are going to do, what we are going now, we are perform calculation for some model which interplay between light and heavy quarks. So maybe this model is more realistic. So in any case, my collaborator write code, which is maybe useful for real experimental data, and also we are supposed to do calculation for other quantities. And this is just a list of last references on this subject. Okay, thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much. We have a couple of questions probably, please. I don't see any raised hand or any. Oh, yes, please. Yes, Ruslan.
Please show Lagrangian of your model. And
Oh, yes.
I understood that the gravity, the field F1 and the scalar field are the commonly used fields which other people are using. And you suggest to add the two fields, F2 and FB. Mm-hmm. Is it correct?
Mm-hmm.
And so all your new results are based on the use of the two fields, F2,
yes,
F2 and
exactly,
FB.
Exactly. To be absolutely honest, I dare to say it is Vara paper which also use this field. For example, Gursoy, for example, who wrote a little bit later, his paper he also used. Later of us, couple of days after, he used also couple of field. But people use sometime scalar, extra scalar field. I don't know, but to get Lipschitz type of solution, where people deal with Lipschitz metric in condensed matter, they use the magnetic field. So this is so what we did. We just married all together.
So to have some matching with latest data or with experiments, you need at least add two fields.
I would say we need two fields, yes.
But my question is, you know that why not to try to use of other fields? I mean, for example, Carl Bramon fields, which we know is appearing in string theory. What is going if what is happens if we add instead of one of the fields, say Carl Bramon fields, antisymmetric field?
Yes, this is a good proposal. I would say we do this historically. Maybe when we will finish this project, maybe we will try to use more close to strings.
But anyway, this is phenomenological approach, so it's not
yes,
just
for sure. Definitely, this is phenomenological approach with very tough rungs. You start from metric, then this method called graphic reconstruction method. We start from metric, then try to find the action which supported this metric. This means that this metric should be solution of equation of motion. And then you do or calculate what you can.
And then you use latest data to fix
some of this function. For example, if
at some point of mu and b, you show that at some point mu equal to zero. And then after fixing of the function at some point, you have some predictions for arbitrary values
for
of
mu and b. Yes, exactly.
I see. Thank you.
Okay
thank you very much. I'm sorry, but we have to cut these questions and we postpone it for discussion part.